in the spirit of my naivete, I then set out to understand why that could be. I mean, that is why our response was what it was time and again, and why it was that we learned so few lessons across time. Part of what was important about the story was that we have made a series of commitments in terms of education and putting a museum on the mall with our country's most treasured monument. I mean, this is a big deal, you know, and so there is something I wouldn't call 1945 a turning point, but certainly maybe the late 1970s when the commitment, you know, really begins to take hold and the Holocaust ceases to be a dirty word. It will forever be a dirty word, hopefully, but becomes a discussed dirty word and when given the attention it deserves. I wanted to look at that, at the sort of before and after too, a little bit, and say, well, okay, what has the Holocaust actually given us in terms of, again, lessons and in terms of a stretching at least of the moral imagination, such that when atrocity happens in other places, we're something different. We as individuals, we as government actors, whatever we are, in, you know, whatever hat we're wearing, you know, is there a shift? Or does it set the bar too high? Is actually the problem that we set the bar at 6 million and at an intention to exterminate every last one of a specific group, which very few post-Holocaust cases, that criteria very few would meet. Rwanda actually happens to meet it, but it's very difficult to see if a case is going to meet it until after you've counted the bodies and uncovered the documents and